Hello everyone, welcome to Civil Engineering Shiloh's updates. In this video, we are going to see how to get plan approval, its procedure, cost and time. First, let's start with the process. The process to get building plan approval varies from area to area. It depends on whether the area comes under corporation limit or metropolitan area like CMDA. CMDA means Chennai Metropolitan Development Authority, or whether it comes under Panchayat limit. Now let's see the corporation limit approval process. The required documents for the approval process are sale deed. Sale deed from 1975 inclusive of all the mother documents also. Second one is patta. Patta should be in owner's name. If it is in some other person's name, name transfer should be done. Next one is EC. EC means encumbrance certificate. Encumbrance certificate from 1975 till date, that is up to current month, is needed. Plot layout. Plot layout mostly will be in the patta itself. If it is not there in patta, plot layout must be attached. Floor plan. We need to submit the floor plans along with the other documents. Floor plan is working drawing, which is also mandatory one. Setback limit. We should know the setback limit also. Let's consider a plot size of about 40 feet into 50 feet. That is 2000 square feet, which is in city area, city limit area, on less than 30 feet road. For 30 feet road, we need to leave 5 feet as setback on all the sides. For 40 feet road, we need to leave 10 feet at front and 5 feet on all the other sides. And this is for stilt plus 3 building. If the number of floor increases, the setback will also change. And so, this is the process. For corporation plan approval, first we need to make sure whether all the documents to get approval are ready along with the floor plan. Then, these documents can be given to a licensed surveyor. As per the standards and norms, the licensed surveyor will create or make some changes in our drawing, and he will upload through online to get approval. If the drawing has been approved, we will be receiving COC number for the drawing submitted. COC means Certificate of Occupancy. We have to take a copy of OC drawing along with the other mentioned document and submit it in the approval office. After submitting those documents, the AE, Assistant Engineer, will sign and approve the file or documents. AE will also sign in our working drawing, that is floor plan. And they will give a demand advice slip. We get to know about the legal approval fees only after receiving the demand advice slip. The mentioned fees has to be paid to the government either as demand draft or as online payment. This was the last step in approval process. Many of you may have doubt that how much will it cost for getting approval. The honest answer is no one exactly knows how much it costs for the approval. Even the assistant engineer who is signing a document don't know the exact cost before calculation. Only after calculation and checking we get to know about the cost. And this will be on the demand advice slip. So, we can say only the approximate cost. Approval cost will not be same in all the areas. So, this is the corporation approval process. Now, let's see about the panchayat limit approval process. If the area comes under panchayat, the process is somewhat different. Here, we need to get planning permit as well as the building permit also. In planning permit, they will check whether the plan is okay or not. If there are any corrections are there, they will check only that. But in building permit, they will calculate the overall built-up area and charges will be asked to the customer based on the total value. Each permit have a different time frame, like 3 years or 5 years. The building should be constructed within that time limit or else we have to get the re-approval. For panchayat approval also, the same documents as I have told you already for corporation approval is needed, like sale deed, patta, encumbrance certificate. But here we need to submit the blueprint drawing with color shading in approval office. They will check our plan and give corrections. It may take 2 to 3 corrections also. Again, we have to correct it and resubmit it in the concerned office. Once our corrections are done, we have to pay fees as challan and as demand draft. After the payment is done, the approver signs the drawing. And now the planning permit is over. After receiving the planning permit, we have to get the building permit in local panchayat office. In building plan approval, they will calculate the total build-up area and cost for building plan approval. Once we pay this amount, we will receive building permit. Therefore, the corporation limit approval process and panchayat limit approval process is totally different process. To get approval, minimum it takes 1.5 to 2 months because the documents will be checked by the various authorities and also it will be done only in the working days. Like that, it can take minimum 1.5 to 2 months. So this is the procedure to get plan approval. I hope this video is helpful to you. If you like this video, kindly subscribe Civil Engineering Shailu's updates and also click the bell icon near to it. Share this video to your friends and do support Civil Engineering Shailu's updates. Thank you.